Over the last decade or so, our economy has become extremely dependent on migrant labour. Our universities have become very dependent financially on foreign students. Large numbers of people who've already come here want to bring their relatives or maybe their fiancés to this country. Abroad, meanwhile, something we don't always realise is much of the rest of Europe is facing population pressures which are very different to ours. In the south, the east and the centre of the continent, countries like as dispersed as Italy to Poland, Greece, Italy, populations left to their own devices would be starting to fall dramatically. Many of those countries have actually had much higher immigration than ours. Many of those immigrants have come from North Africa, the Middle East, areas on the other side of the Mediterranean where large population growth is still underway. So all of those things are going to impact on us. All of those things are going to mean that whatever the domestic political pressures, whatever the domestic policy makers may say, immigration is going to remain an extremely thorny and complicated problem for the foreseeable future, which is one reason why I hope this evening we'll have a very good discussion.
Let's start with the... this is net immigration into the England, not the UK. 90% go to England. And as you can see, it was negative in the 80s. It was pretty small until the mid-90s. And since the mid-90s, it has shot up. And we're now looking at the order of 250,000 a year. And it's no surprise that public opinion has matched it. It has grown pretty well as immigration itself has grown. The most latest one will be a bit further down here. Because, of course, the financial crisis overtook it. But it's still, of course, the second issue, well above many others. Intentions change and so on and so forth. But essentially, the green line there is spouses, and that has doubled since 97 when they changed the rules, which had some impact. The magenta line with a big spike in the year 2000 is asylum. Asylum is now down to applications down to 25,000 a year. That is only 10% of net foreign immigration. So if you're talking numbers, and we are talking numbers, asylum is not the issue. There are a lot of sensitive issues in asylum, but it's not an immigration issue. So we don't talk about it, at least not recently and not much. What has grown very substantially is, of course, work permits, and that is the red line, which you can see shot up in about the year 2000. Present government have trebled the number of work permits, and that is part of the explanation for the sharp increase in...
I think the problem with this issue is that if you do get seduced into the idea of saying let's have a cap, and particularly if you try and get the cap down to the levels of the 1990s, to the sort of 40,000 areas, you are going to have to bite into those areas where, one, I think the economic damage and the social damage might be quite high. And there's another factor which I think needs to be borne in mind. I'm at the moment sort of doing nothing but eat, sleep and write a big policy paper on irregular migration, so it's very much in my head. But one of the problems is if there aren't legal routes, then they're going to come another way, because the demand to come is absolutely enormous, and we need to bear that in mind. And I think there are some times when it would be better to have some routes for people to come in a way that we can control and manage and on our terms, if you like, and for the benefit of them, because working in the shadow economy is no fun for anybody. It would be much better if we controlled that by having some routes for these people, even if it's at the cost of a bit more legal immigration.
I think we should actually not allow population to grow over 65 million. So we would be back to a balanced migration policy. The 100,000 leaving, which is, says something about this country, those numbers, will be matched by 100,000 new citizens. That would be the limit. And that would be the guidelines that one would actually give to ministers. One is, we're not going to grow any more as we've done in the past, without any consultation, without any permission, without any by your leave, to grow the population by immigration. Secondly, we need to break the link between coming here to work, which is good for the economy, and people automatically getting citizenship. Thirdly, that citizenship should be the real issue about the numbers who can permanently remain here.